only war during near Jericho. He had not entered Jericho. That was yesterday. And then he met the blind man. The blind man was at the fringe of the city of Jericho. Jesus was approaching Jericho. And then he met this blind man. But did Jesus stop there? No! He moved on. He transited. Child of the living God, he moved on. He was not stagnant. In today's gospel text, when you listened, you will understand the word of God says, and Jesus what? Enter Jericho. Ay-ay-ay-ay. You will not just get close to your blessing, you will enter. I say you will enter. I say you will enter. I say you will enter. You will not just get close to your blessing, you will enter that blessing in the name of Jesus. Titus, I say you will enter that blessing in the name of Jesus. I say you will enter the land of blessing. I say you will enter the land of blessing. I say you will not enter. You will not just be close, you will enter in the name of Jesus. Yesterday he was at the fringe, but as the Lord lived, he saw the stagnant man. You will not just see the NYC camp, you will get into it in the name of Jesus. You will come out and you will grow higher in the name of Jesus. You will not die during service here in the name of Jesus. I say, compass, you will not die in the name of Jesus. I say, you will not die in the name of Jesus. Whether you are in Zamfara, whether you are in Burundi, whether you are in Sokoto, whether you are in Kaduna, in whatsoever dominated crisis you are, we pray for you, you corpus. The Lord will protect you. The oil of preservation is over you. I say you will not die. You will come out successfully. You will come out successfully. The parents are praying for you. The church is praying for you. You will not die in the name of Jesus. Jesus was at the fringe of Jericho. He met the blind man, changed his life, and he entered Jericho. I pray that you will come close to your blessing, your land of blessing. You will enter and you will enjoy your blessings in the name of Jesus. Let me preach. Many of you do not know the type of money uncommon money tax collectors of the time of Jesus had. This man, Zacchaeus, the man that will reach me here, though I am not tall here, if this man stand up, like this man, maybe he will be reaching him the knee. That was how short the man was, but he had too much money. Too much money. Perhaps the people like their Dangote, or maybe people that you think are rich, leading his time, they will reward his own servants. The man had too much money. Too much money. Listen to me. For you to qualify to be a tax collector at the time of Jesus, your money may have doubled, tripled, quadrupled, to a point that you can pay the tax of everybody in the land all at once. And you will still have plenty left to before you will qualify to be a tax collector. So tax collectors at that time were carefully choosing among the super rich, and they traded and they made business out of it. So when time for payment of taxes come, children of the living God, they will count all the people in the land together with infants, and they will give them the deal, 30 billion, and they will open their storehouses. They will bring it all out, and they will pay to the Romans once. If they had paid 10,000 for each person in the community, it is now permissible to them to collect any amount from everybody. Are you hearing me? So if you have collected 10,000 from everybody, they will go ahead to collect 20,000, and the government of the Romans will not see anything. That's why they were hated. They were extortionists. They will pay a little on your head and they will collect so much. So it was a big business. This man was super rich. This man, let me blow English, he was stupendously rich. The statues of his own money. Child of the living God, this man, Zacchaeus, He was very rich. However, he was a pocket-sized man. However, he was short. Say, however, he was short. Listen to me. Be humble. If you have money, money cannot give you everything. Money cannot buy everything. I say money cannot buy everything. I say money cannot buy everything. I say money cannot buy everything. You may have plenty of money, child of the living God, but you may not have heart. A poor person may have tall, good height, and with your money you will be very short. There is nothing you can do about it. Many of you who are football fans, you know Lionel Messi. Read about him, and he was very short and brief. Because of money, because of the talent they saw in him, they injected growth hormones. He sort of so that at least he will jump up a little, but he's still a dwarf. He's still very short. I respect him, and I respect what God is doing in his life, but he's short. So let nobody intimidate you because he has money. There is something in your life that he does not have. So when somebody will say this life no balance now, this life balance, whatever has, you know you have something he does not have. What that rich man has that you do not have, you know you have something that he does not want have. The man was rich, but he was short. Very short people were passing and had no problem seeing Jesus. Say, Jesus, alright. And this very rich man that had money was very short. He was trying to look for a position. Trying to look for a position where he could get a glimpse of Jesus. Listen to me now. If somebody of that financial status is trying to get a glimpse of Jesus, do you know the type of person Jesus was when he was walking this earth? Then you know the respect and the honor Jesus commands. Today, some rich people will disregard him. And I will say on that day, Zacchaeus will arise and he will condemn you. Because he tell you, before my time, at my time, you were a poor man, but I honor this man. Is somebody hearing me? Yes. Any rich man who thinks we will disrespect or dishonor Jesus because he has money. Zacchaeus will accuse you that if you had lived at my time, you would be my poor. You will be going errand for me, but I honor this man. Come on. He honored him. We are told he wanted to see Jesus. And he could and he rode. And he climbed the sycamore tree. He threw his Africa away. Do you know what it means? A tax collector, a very important personality, though a sinner, going to climb on a tree. He said to himself, to hell with my social status, to hell with my money, to hell with whatsoever they look at me, I am seeing this man. And so he climbed the sycamore tree. My friend, be there with your poverty, thinking you have money, and be this, respecting, dishonoring Jesus. You will die in hell with your money. I say you will die in hell with your money. I say you will die in hell with your money. Be for me then. James chapter 5. Read the word of God. James chapter 5, from verse number 1 down to 4. Let them read. If you think you are glory, you are basking in the glory of your wealth, thinking your money will save you. I make reference to James chapter 5, from verse number 1. Come now, you men who think you are wealthy, give yourselves to weeping and crying because of the bitter troubles that are coming for you. Your wealth is unclean, and incest will not make holes in them. Go ahead. And also your clothing, your gold, your silver, you are wasted. Their waste will be a witness against you. Burning in your flesh, you have put by your stores in the lasting days. See the money that you have. See the money that you have. The firstly kept back from the workers cutting the grass.
your fear
is crying against you in heaven. God is awaiting for you there. I say, he's awaiting for you there. He's crying out against you, and the cry of those you took in their greed have come to the ears of the Lord of war. And if you read my version, it says, miserable you are. Miserable, you think you are rich, but you do not know that you are poor, wretched, and naked. That is what his word says. For this man, Zacchaeus, he did not want to die naked. He did not want to die wretched. And so he sought the friendship of Jesus. Maxwell, this man was rich. He sought what? The friendship of Jesus. And when Jesus saw him and he saw the hunger in this man to have healing in his heart, Jesus said, come down, I will be with you. Listen to me now. Jesus was not just going in the physical house of Zacchaeus. He was going into his heart. Revelation chapter 3, verse number 20. I stand on the door of your heart and I knock. If you open, I will come in and I will eat with you. So that feast that Jesus did, the banquet that Jesus had in the life, in the house of Zacchaeus, it was not just a physical house. It was what? His heart. His heart. Touch your heart. It was his heart. It was his heart. Listen to me. The heart of Zacchaeus was pierced and it was full. Oh, with the presence of Jesus and before the meal. Oh, God, to a finish. He jumped up and he said, I have a confession to make. 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 And his friends who were rich thought he was mad. Just like Eliezer was thought to have been mad. You know, there is a certain level you grow in the spirit. You work for the Lord. You do your Christianity that people will think you are mad. If you have not gotten to that level, you have not started. If you are not praying, Father, that people will think you are mad, you have not started. It is not you. Eliezer was taught to be mad. Zacchaeus was taught to be mad by his friends. When he took his hand up before Jesus, hey, I have a confession. I have a confession. It is when Jesus penetrates your heart that you can freely make confession. I say you can freely make confession. Somebody who Jesus touches her heart. You remember the other time somebody came out. He said, I am a harlot. A girl was touching her chest. She didn't bother because Jesus took what? Her heart. Jesus took her heart. She came under cameras and she was saying, I used to collect people's husbands. I did terrible things. I used to steal. It is when Jesus touches your heart that when they make an altar call, just look as you run out, you will run out. If you are set with your daughter or your mother, somebody an altar call of such that the man has slid with his own daughter, come out, and the man run out and say, here I am, have mercy on me, under cameras. A man slept with his daughter. And she ran and came to the altar. Here I am, Lord, have mercy on me. When God takes over your heart, you can make any confession without what? Bothering. The man Zacchaeus, because Jesus had gotten into his heart, he made a confession. Has Jesus gotten a place in your heart? Yes, if you are you over there. Now, yes, if you are you over there. More teenage are you that in years. As you call the name of Jesus, I pray that you will have a woman in your heart in the name of Jesus. Huh? One day, a woman went for a power program like this program, and he went back. Because Jesus had gotten into her heart. He called the husband, sit here. I want to talk to you. I want to make a confession. 3 out of the 5 children are all yours. Ay, 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 ay. Oh, mama mia. Though I will not advise anybody to do such. Don't make such a confession to your husband. Better make it to the priest. But listen to me.
scene.
When Jesus takes in a place there, when he takes in the place there, child of the living God, nothing is shameful anymore. I say nothing is shameful anymore. Has it a place in your heart? Has it a place in your heart? Are you sure? Are you sure? Has he a place in your heart? That tiny himself, fornication. I'm saying tiny, meaning that you can like say it out. You go to confession and you try to conceal it. After you have done confession, you remember very well you committed fornication. I say, Father, and the others I cannot remember. You did not even do any confession. That is a bad confession. Remember, when you go to confession, the priest will bless you. That let the grace of God take over your life and you'll be able to make a good confession. But you knew very well that you committed that sin. But you are like looking at yourself, I am a knight. Oh, I am a prayer warrior. I am this. You begin to look at your social status, your religious status, and then you dip yourself deep into sin. Zacchaeus didn't do that. He said to the Lord, oh, I have a confession. I have been a terrible and a big cheat. But today, because you have come into my heart, I am going to what? Pay four times over. Imagine that type of money. And still, he will still remain with money. He will not go broke. I say you will not go broke. I will pay what? Four times over. Four times. One, two, three, four. Four times over. I will go to the books. My accountant. We what? We go through my history books. Anyone I have defrauded, I will pay four times over. And I give what? Half. Half of my what? My riches to the poor. Half. This man money long. Hey, half you are giving to the poor, you will still pay four times over. So what do you? We will you have left to eat? But it is still there. It did not matter. It didn't matter to him whether he will go broke in the physical, but he will be rich in the spirit. Is somebody hearing me now? All what the man was after is richness in the heart. Richness in the heart. Richness in the heart. He wanted to have a peaceful sleep. And so he gave half of his property, his wealth, to the poor. Four times over, if you have defrauded anyone, in the name of Jesus, I pray. Well, that the Lord will take over your hearts in the name of Jesus. I say, he will take over your hearts in the name of Jesus. That there will be a turnaround in our lives in the name of Jesus. There will be a turnaround in our lives in the name of Jesus. Let me ask you. Will you be bold enough to go to that woman to confess, to tell her that, woman, I have come to apologize, I have received Jesus. I used to go out with your husband, but honestly, I have stopped. Take it from me. How many of you will be bold to do that? How many of you will even be bold to go that I'm sorry, Mr. David? I did this and this against you. I spoke bad against you. I plotted evil against your child. Forgive me today. I'm a true Christian. I'm a born again. If you have not gotten to that point, Jesus has taken only half of your heart. If he takes full, you will have no problem doing that. And you will not budge. You will tell the woman, I have told you, name and window, I am at peace. If you keep me in your mind, it is you that know me. I have received Jesus. I will go back now and I will sleep soundly. I have confessed my sin to you. I have told you. And I will never go back to that life. How many of you? We go to that woman you cheated. You were bladder. Never you. Can anybody hear it? Flip. Not bladder. Me in tablet. We have your blue shall apply to be better by your name, Mashima. How many of us? How many of you will go to the priest and say, Father, I have eaten church collection. That's why things are not where we need. I have stolen from the church. How many? Children of the living God, when Jesus takes over your heart, then you are a new person. some things I used to do, I do them no more. Some things I used to do, I do them no more. Some things I used to do, I do them no more. There is a great change since I'm born again. Sing it one more. Some things I used to do, I do them no more. Oh my God. Some things I used to do, I do them no more, Jesus. Some things I used to do, I do them no more. There is a great change since I'm born again. For Zacchaeus, he told Jesus, things I used to do, I will do them no more, because you have come into my life. I pray that such may be your confession to the Lord this day. Some things you used to do, you will do them no more. Amen. You will no longer take drugs in the name of Jesus. Amen. You will no longer be a drunkard in the name of Jesus. Amen. You will no longer bully your wife, beat your wife in the name of Jesus. Amen. You will no longer do evil in the name of Jesus. Amen. And the Lord, help us to experience a complete turnaround in the spirit, so that even when we die in the flesh, we shall live with the Lord in the Spirit through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I exercise.